Let's conduct some analysis in ArcGIS Pro. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel for another tutorial. Before you continue to watch, please take a moment to hit subscribe below if you haven't already done so. So today we continue our ArcGIS Pro series and we'll be conducting simple analysis in ArcGIS Pro. In my last tutorial, we explored 3D within ArcGIS Pro, so you can check that out at the top of this video right now. Anyhow, let's get into today's topic. So as I mentioned, we will be conducting simple analysis in ArcGIS Pro. I have a couple tutorials already on getting started with ArcGIS Pro, so if you're not here yet, then you can check out my playlist of ArcGIS Pro tutorials so far at the end of this video or at the top of this tutorial right now. So when we talk about analysis in GIS, we are referring to spatial analysis, which looks at the relationships, location, and attributes of features in spatial data using different techniques. Essentially, analysis can help to solve a problem, and this usually begins with a question, a geographic question. In ArcGIS Pro, like ArcMap, there are many tools available to help you answer questions about proximity, overlay, spatial patterns, and temporal changes. Analysis in ArcGIS Pro or ArcMap can be done in three ways: by running a single geoprocessing tool at a time, or by creating a model in Model Builder. Let me know in the comments below if you want a tutorial on creating a model in Model Builder using ArcGIS Pro or ArcMap. You can also use Python script. These also apply to raster analysis. However, we won't cover that in this tutorial. Jarlath O'Neill Dunn, I hope I'm getting his name correct, has some really good tutorials on raster in ArcGIS Pro, so I'll link one of my favorites below. In my scenario, there has been a fire at the local landfill, and we need to determine the areas that have been affected and at the intensity. So we will create a multi-ring buffer around the landfill with 3 rings at 1 kilometer, 5 kilometers, and 10 kilometers. We will also clip the nearest schools to determine which schools need to be closed and for how long. We may need to evacuate persons from their homes or businesses so we can find out how many houses or businesses have been impacted. First, we will start with the multi-ring buffer. In our ArcGIS Pro project, we go to the Analysis tab, and one thing to note is that you can see the most commonly used tools readily available here. We select Tools and search for the Multi-Ring Buffer tool. The distances to include are 1 kilometer. This is the area that is most critical. Schools here will be closed and persons will be asked to evacuate their homes, as it is expected that this area will be covered in smoke and ashes. At 5 kilometers, there may be smoke and ashes, so this area will be under watch. At 10 kilometers, there may be ashes but little smoke. Once the rings are drawn, we add the attribute details to differentiate the critical areas in the multi-ring buffer. We We will extract the schools that must be closed immediately and homes or businesses that will be evacuated. This data will also include the status of the affected area. Following the extraction of the critical schools, those schools under watch, and those with little to no impact will also be extracted, along with the status being included. I first use the intersect tool to extract the schools within each buffer zone, as this will provide me with the school details as well as the current status all in one. After using the intersect tool to extract the schools that are in the critical zone, it is determined that only one school will need to be evacuated immediately, as this is the only one that lies within the zone. I will only clip the critical buildings, as I won't need any further information other than which buildings should be evacuated. However, later on, we decided that we need a little more information for the buildings other than what should be ordered closed immediately. We also need the status along with the boundaries for the most critical area. So here, I will use the Union tool to provide this information. So we conducted simple analysis using the multi-ring buffer tool, the intersect tool, the clip, as well as the union tool. With this information, we will be able to facilitate evacuations as well as prepare any maps or reports needed. So guys, this is actually the last plan tutorial for ArcGIS Pro, but don't worry, I'll still post ArcGIS Pro tip videos. In upcoming tutorials, look out for creating your operations dashboard in ArcGIS Online and some customization for story maps. As usual, thank you so much for watching, and please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this tutorial with a friend or colleague who you believe would benefit from this information. Also, leave a comment down below to let me know how you like the tutorial so far, or if you have any other tutorials that you would like to see. Thanks again, and see you next time.